Hi everyone, in this video I'm going to talk about Raspberry Pi. So what is the Raspberry Pi? This is what you can see over here. At least it's one card out of the many which are available, and it's a full computer. Okay, it's a full computer where you have the microprocessor, you get the different ports, you get the possibility to append any electric components such as LED, such as motion sensor, whatever. Then you have extra ports in order to make it exactly like a computer. So it's a tiny computer which does not cost a lot of money. Actually, the standard model are about $35, and the let's say the cheapest one is at $5, and it's really, really popular within the mobile world, or let's say the Internet of Things world. What makes it popular as well among the open source community is that most of the operating system which are used on it are GNU Linux, so that's why also it's very famous. Though actually the Raspberry Pi is not an open source hardware. So this is what it is about. Here's the official website on which you can purchase official Raspberry Pi card. You can of course get those on AliExpress, but this is the official website where you can get them. It gives you a clear idea of the, let's say, the different characteristic of the computer. So as you can see, you get RAM within it. I mean, it's kind of really interesting computer that you can play with in order to watch video, in order to make IoT projects. You can really do a lot of things. As you can see, that's really a full computer. Here's the Raspberry Pi Zero, so that's the cheapest one that you can find, so it costs only $5. But the point is that it's going to cost you a lot of money in order to get the different additional, let's say, components that you need to plug to it, such as the keyboard, such as the screen, because as you can see, it's just mini ports. So in any cases, you need adapter, and that's probably what's going to make and the thing a little bit more expensive. As you can see here, at the end of the day, it's finally $30. Okay, that's what I wanted to tell you about the Raspberry Pi. So we're gonna switch now to my desk, and on my desk, as you can see, we have two cards. I did it on purpose. One is blue and one is green. And so for you, it's just two colors card. They do not have much difference, but they have. This one, the blue one, is an Arduino card. Okay, I already talked about Arduino in another video, and the point of Arduino card and what's the difference between Raspberry Pi and an Arduino Uno. An Arduino is designed in order to have only one single program, or even let's say several programs within it, but that's the only thing that what an Arduino Uno can do, right? It can just read a couple of programs, and that's it. You cannot install any software on it. You cannot do much. In fact, it's really designed in order to make a connected device, and that's it, period. That's an Arduino Uno. So of course this one is far cheaper than this one, because this one, the green one, is a Raspberry Pi, and the Raspberry Pi is a full computer, right? So it runs with an operating system. It can even run on Microsoft Windows. Where the operating system is gonna run, it's gonna run on the hard disk, and the hard disk is nothing more in my case than an SD card. Okay, so you just need to upload on this given card an operating system, and then you can run it on the Raspberry Pi in itself, and like this you can after have your own computer exactly like on the video that I was on the website that I was showing you some seconds ago. And here you get, in fact, exactly like the Arduino Uno, the possibility to append, in fact, some let's say electric components such as LEDs, such as any other things like this, in order to make it as a mobile project on which you can interact with several other connected devices. So it's very, very powerful. It doesn't cost much, and that's why this is really popular, because it means that you can embed it in many mobile projects, or you can even have a computer for a very cheap price that you can let within a room or within a house in order to collect a lot of data or do specific tasks. As you can see, you get many different ports that you're already familiar with. And let's say the hardest part for you is just to find out the different components, such as the keyboard, such as the screen, that you will append to it without breaking the bank. And yeah, of course, as it's a real computer, you can even use it in order to host website, to access to it remotely, and so on and so forth. So to make it simple, Raspberry Pi is a cheap and tiny computer in order to enter within the Internet of Things market. I really hope that you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching.